Hey everybody, welcome to Kim's Fake Cooking Show. Yes, it's Kim, barefoot in the kitchen, cooking real good food for you today on my fake cooking show in my real kitchen. Thank you for tuning in. Today we are making barbecue pulled mushrooms. We're using king mushrooms because king mushrooms are high in iron, but they have a lot of fiber. And those are a couple of things that we really need. Full of B vitamins, potassium, and they're just super good for you. So let's get going on this recipe, barbecue pulled mushrooms. Today we've got mushrooms. The recipe asks for five. Five is never enough for me, so I'm cooking with eight today. Two cloves of garlic. We've got olive oil, cayenne pepper, smoked paprika, and salt. And that's it. Super easy recipe. You don't need a lot of ingredients, and it cooks up really fast. This recipe is 30 minutes start to finish. That includes cooking time. So it's a great recipe if you are super busy, and it's a really good one to work into your weekly meal rotations, especially if you do meatless Mondays, because this tastes a lot like pulled pork. Not that I've ever had pulled pork, but my friends that have tasted this recipe have said, oh my goodness, to them, it's just a ringer for pulled pork. But anyway, it tastes awesome. I would not be doing a recipe on my cooking show that doesn't taste awesome. So what we want to do first of all is crush our two cloves of garlic. If you've got a garlic crusher, that's great. I don't. Someday I will get back to IKEA and buy one. So I'm gonna do this by hand. You're gonna wanna, if you're doing it by hand, you're gonna wanna mince it up fairly fine. And with your garlic, you guys know, give it a press with your knife, and then those skins pop off super easy. And I've got a baking sheet beside me, and it already has parchment paper on it, wax paper, whatever you guys use. I don't recommend doing this on a baking sheet unless it has some paper on it, because some parts of the king mushrooms are going to get kind of crispy, and you don't want them to be stuck to the bottom of your pan. If you don't have any baking paper, parchment paper, then go ahead and do this recipe in a glass bottom pan that you've greased, or you've sprayed it with some Pam or whatever cooking spray that you have. Okay, my garlic is already chopped and it's going onto my baking sheet there. Now we're gonna have a go at these king mushrooms. With the mushrooms, they're going to come to you fairly clean already, but go ahead and grab a wet paper towel and give them a wipe just to make sure that they are clean to your standards. I don't recommend soaking them at all. You don't want the mushrooms to absorb any water. They'll change the consistency, and that is just not necessary. So give them a wipe, and when they're clean enough, we're going to go ahead and take one with two forks and a fork at the top, and then with your other fork you're just going to go ahead and shred. This part's kind of fun. I like it. And if you've got big ones, you're going to shred on one side and then go ahead, turn it over, and shred on the other side. The head sometimes pops off, and if it does, well, you're going to do this anyway. Just slice it up, put it on your pan. And if you've got a mushroom that's got sort of a gnarly bottom, this is how we deal with that. Cut off the gnarly bottom part, and it's already kind of shredded there. And just go ahead and finish shredding that bottom part by hand, throwing it in your pan. And you've already washed your hands, right? This is the era of COVID, and we want everything to be super clean. Okay, now this is the other part you've got left over. That's the stem. And we're just going to finish doing that one by hand, bring it on the pan. And some of them you want to be nice and thin, and some of them a little bit thicker. These ones will be kind of I would call it sort of a meatier feeling, a little bit thicker. And you want some of the pieces to be thin, because those are the pieces that are going to get nice and crispy. And it's going to add just some nice texture variation to your mushrooms. Fork at the top, and then you don't have to really go at it with too much force. The mushrooms are soft to begin with. There we go, this one is ready. You still here with me? Okay, here we go. This is so good. I'm already super excited and a little bit hungry. Fork at the top, shred, shred, shred. Turn it on the side, shred, shred, shred. Oh, this is gonna taste amazing. I'm so excited to introduce this recipe to you. Now be careful, you don't want pieces that are too big, because it all has to cook at the same time. One more to go. Here we go. Turn it on its side. I'm going to give the bottom a little bit more love here because it's on the thicker side. Good. One more side. And the top is ready to go in the pan already. Shred, shred, shred. Sometimes you'll get a package of king mushrooms that doesn't have such a thick stems, and those ones are easier to shred. Not that any of this is very difficult, you know, right? Okay. So, and then I've got the tops of the mushrooms here. They're dealt with a different way. Just slice them. Not too thin. Not too thick. Slice them just right. Okay. About like that. And then they will cook all at the same time. And that's what that looks like. Let's get already. 2 tablespoons. If you're really counting calories, you can get away with 1 tablespoon. I have done it that way before. It's okay. I'm doing 2 today because I got a fair amount of mushrooms there. 1 teaspoon paprika. There we go. That's looking good. And we want 1/4 teaspoon of the cayenne pepper. Yum, 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 yum. Oh. Super easy. That's it. And then use your hands or your forks, and you're just going to make sure that that's all incorporated together. I'm going to go ahead and use my hands here, just to make sure that you can feel that the oil is being evenly distributed. Sort of rub those spices in. And we also want to do, the recipe doesn't really call for salt, but I have done it both ways and I like it with just a little bit of salt lightly sprinkled on the top, and then again just give it another little toss. So I'm going to go ahead and pop this in the oven for 20 minutes at 350. Now we're going to turn our attention to the asparagus while our mushrooms are baking in the oven. And I did say earlier to bake them at 350. Change. Bake them at 400. When I looked at my oven, I remembered 400 is a better temperature. I've done them both ways, and 400 does turn out a little bit quicker, and I like the texture a little bit better. So bake them at 400 degrees for 20 minutes. Check them at the 15 minute mark just to make sure that the crispy parts are not getting too crispy. So let's turn our attention now to our baked asparagus. I do love asparagus. And the best way to get rid of those woody stem parts that you don't like is just to take a bunch like this and bend them. And you'll notice that they all bend off, they all break off at different lengths. And I guarantee you, this is the part that you don't want. It doesn't leave you with very much at the end, but this is the very best part. So it just naturally takes off the woody parts that way. So a bunch and break. Yummy, yummy. This is gonna be such a good dinner. Asparagus and pickled mushrooms. There we go. Okay. So there on your sheet or your baking pan. Again, for easy cleanup and just to make sure that they don't get stuck to anything, I line everything with parchment paper, olive oil. It's good for you. And just depends on how much you're cooking. I don't have a lot of asparagus here. It's only a meal for one. And so a half of a tablespoon is going to do it for me. And then a little bit of salt, a little bit of pink salt. I'm looking at not a lot here, so about a scant half teaspoon. And then we're just going to, there we go, mix that all together. This is the fun part. And then this actually is going to go in the last 8 minutes of the pulled mushrooms. I'm just going to put the pulled mushrooms and push them sort of together in the pan and then cook the asparagus in the same pan as the mushrooms because I'm only cooking for one. If you're cooking for a family, then go ahead and put your full pan of asparagus in there as well. Now, let's go check on those mushrooms and see how they're coming along. Okay, how did you do? How did your mushrooms and your asparagus turn out? Mine turned out, well, it looks good. I haven't tasted it yet, but it looks really good. And this is what you want it to look like in the end. So you've got your mushrooms here, and you've got some parts that are quite crispy, and then you've got some that are a little bit meatier, juicier looking, and that's what you want it to look like at the end. Doesn't that look good? Oh, yum, I can't wait. And the asparagus is just a teeny bit firm, so it's not all mushy, and it looks like it's really good too. Haven't tasted it yet, but I'm looking forward to that. Now the next step, I skip if I'm cooking it just for myself, because if it's just me, it goes straight out of the oven and mixed with barbecue sauce and then into my belly. But if you are cooking for a crowd, you might do up the pulled mushrooms first, and then once company is almost ready to eat, then you'll put them into the pan along with the barbecue sauce and saute for 3 to 5 minutes. So I'm just going to go ahead and show it to you anyway. This is, choose your barbecue sauce carefully, right? It'd be nice if I would have had time and resources to make my own barbecue sauce, but anyway, what I could find was Heinz barbecue sauce. There were others, but the first ingredient in them was sugar. And in this one, it's the third ingredient, so I feel not quite so bad about using it. So we want a 1/4 cup. Let me just double check that. Yeah, a 1/4 cup of barbecue sauce. I'm gonna turn on my cooking service here and select cooking, and 1/4 cup barbecue sauce. There it goes in the pan. Good stuff. Over there it goes. And then I'm going to add my mushrooms. Scratch anything. and they give your hand a little bit of distance from the hot surface. So I'm stirring up that barbecue sauce along with those pulled mushrooms. Wow. You guys are gonna love this. So you've got the tang of the barbecue sauce, and then you've got the heat, the kick from the cayenne pepper, and then you've got the smokiness. Sort of like the last taste is the smoked paprika. So, and that's the taste, how it goes through sort of like a roller coaster in your mouth. First of all is the barbecue, and then you taste that cayenne kick, and then the last is that smoked paprika pepper. It's really good. Okay, now asparagus. How did you do? Perfect. Oh my goodness. That is absolutely perfect. Love it. That is barbecue pulled pork and asparagus. Please give it a try. Thank you for watching today. Please hit the I like this recipe, I like this tutorial button. Please give me a thumbs up. Leave a message. I love reading your messages. It makes me so happy. Now, if I can pull it up here, I just wanted to read you a poem. Here it is. So a little bit of poetry tonight with your tutorial. This is one of my favorite poems. It's really, really short. It's by William Butler Yeats. And he said, "Had I the heaven's embroidered cloths and wrought with gold and silver light, the blue and the dim and the dark cloths of night and light and the half light, I would spread the cloths under your feet. But I, being poor, have only my dreams. I have spread my dreams under your feet. Tread softly, because you tread on my dreams." There we go, folks. Be kind to each other. Don't be treading on anybody's dreams. Love you. Thanks for watching. Thanks for coming to my kitchen today. I really hope that you enjoy this recipe.